We have had little or no rain for, it's been a couple of weeks
yeah,
now.
Yeah, it has, and that's taking a toll for a lot of us, certainly our lawns. Chief Meteorologist Steve Raleigh here now to give us a closer look. Steve?
Yeah, guys, let's take a look at some of those stats. You know, it's been a long, dry, hot time for us. And as we look at the precipitation specifically, you'll see what I'm talking about. You know, in the last 24 hours, of course, you know, it's been nothing for the most part, even though we did have some showers around here. Some folks barely even recorded anything. You'll see how it's been for the month and the depth involved, and most importantly is that last stat, since January 1, we're about 4.5 inches down in rainfall. And when you start looking at a long-term situation, what they kind of categorize this is a moderate severity. The drought development, though, is in the likely category, and the crop moisture is abnormally dry. The rainfall needed, we'd need somewhere in the tune of 3 to 6 inches worth, so you know, the heat wave may be over, but it's going to stay dry for a while. In fact, meteorologist Sarah Walters is live in Lawrenceburg after speaking with a hydrologist who's tracking rainfall trends. Sarah, what's the latest?
Well, Steve, I'm in southeast Indiana, as you mentioned, and here is one of the driest places across the tri-state. You also mentioned that over 4.5 inches in Cincinnati area alone. We're behind from where we should be for this time of year. So at this point, the situation has gone well beyond our dry grass and wilted gardens. A dry winter and early spring, lack of rainfall, and then record-breaking temperatures. These have all contributed to the severely dry conditions across the tri-state. I spoke to Julie Reed, the service hydrologist at the National Weather Service, on just how critical our current situation is.
We're kind of getting into more of a what you would call nearly a meteorological drought, meaning just simply rainfall has been well below normal and temperatures have been high.
Reed points out that the hardest hit areas in the tri-state are in southeast Indiana and parts of Butler County, and she said that it's only going to get worse. Unfortunately, these areas didn't get much of Sunday's rain, with most of it falling in northern Kentucky. These folks are dry too, but it's not enough rain to put a stop to our short-term drought.
We were under a ridge of high pressure where a lot of the precipitation was staying north, like in the upper Great Lakes area or in the southeast United States, where it's affecting a good portion of the central and western United States. It's a good chunk of the country that is under this particular type of very dry, very hot pattern.
And this pattern doesn't look like it's going to break. July is a critical month for rainfall in our area. We see almost 4 inches of rain in July, but the forecasts are calling for a really good chance of below average precipitation. So where does this year's drought compare to the drought of 1988? Well, the National Weather Service did a study, and I put a link to that study in the weather section on WCPO.com. Meteorologist Sarah Walters, 9 News, Lawrenceburg.
Thanks, Sarah.